Well, I believe that there are lots of promises already and some applications on the market that could show that when you improve the connectivity of vehicles and vehicles and infrastructure, and also vehicles, infrastructure, and traffic signs, which are part of infrastructure, then you might be able to improve the fluidity of traffic. And one of the big polluters is congestion. There are, for example, pilots or even staged investments about traffic lamps that are able to communicate interactively with vehicles and even predict if congestion is emerging, not only witnessing or analyzing existing congestions, but predicting the emerging congestion, and would be able to send information back to the vehicle and the driver, of course, about some detours, about some change of the itinerary that could facilitate not simply reducing congestion, but avoiding congestion. This would be one of the concrete areas, I believe, where we would benefit for the environment of improved technologies, using IT technologies, information technologies, and connecting vehicles, infrastructure, and the whole environment. But when you ask about environmental impact, I should say that lots of investments are producing co-benefits. When you improve the environment, you have a positive impact on the environment. Most likely you are improving safety as well. Less congestion, less fatigue, drivers pay more attention to driving. So per se, there could be an improvement in safety. And in this regard, I would like to underline that from today till 2020, the world is supposed to halve the fatalities due to road crashes. This is a very ambitious task. It is coming from the Sustainable Development Goals agreed on by the government last September. It is not yet a Vision Zero, but it is moving towards that. So if new technologies are deployed at a fast speed, then maybe the goal is becoming more reachable. Definitely, new technologies will offer not only benefits, but they are coming with risks. We have just discussed at the Network Car event, which is jointly organized by ITU and the United Nations of Economic Commission for Europe, that cybersecurity is one of the concerns. And this is the year, 2016, is the year of cybersecurity. So we have to go into new technologies with open eyes and a lot of understanding and courage. Courage to open up sensitive questions and not to shy away discussing them. Well, it's very difficult for me to know where the industry should focus on, but or the car industry, but there could be one overarching concern or issue that we cannot continue developing any industrial products or services by not linking one industry with the other. So I personally believe that there is some sort of a convergence between the industry in the communication technologies and in the automotive industry. But also on the other side, I see a convergence and the need for more cooperation on behalf of governments and authorities and also international organizations, because we cannot promote simply better road mobility. We have to have safer, cleaner, secure road mobility. But we have to promote mobility which considers pedestrians, which considers the possibility for safe and enjoyable cycling, which is connecting road mobility with rail mobility, cargo mobility from maritime to road. So we need really a multi-sectoral approach to improve the conditions, how people can move around and how cargo can be turned around the globe. Well, I believe that all events when different stakeholders come together with different knowledge and different perspective about the future, and they confront their ideas. I find the meetings where the alike thinking people come together less and less important and useful. Here at the Natural Car event, actually we reach out to the two major sectors, telecommunication and transport and mobility, and that's needed.